Good morning, everybody. It is Friday, and I just have a quick walk around. There's pretty much no more snow, or very, very little. If there's any accumulations, it would be up against the fences in the shady areas. The ground is still frozen. It's been freezing most nights. And I'm going to come around a little quick so I can get some light on my face. The camera will pick up. There we go. And right here, I have some cabbage that I've chopped up. That's for the chickens. That's their roughage for the day. And we've got a gallon of, this was warm tap water, so probably about 110 degrees coming out of the faucet. Of course, there's my hydration needs. Morning coffee. Okay, I'm gonna switch angles. Okay, we start out with the quick changing of the shoes. And I leave my, well, I should probably take it with me. I will. Let's see, I think I can manage this. Yeah. And well, this will be the trickier part. Nope, we got it. So, salad bar for the girls. No dressings. They'll get to pick through the leaves. I'm going to throw this so that they have reason to stomp through things. But first we'll stop and put this stuff down on the garbage can there. That's my little podium. Hello, ladies. Well, they're all kinds of anxious to get out. It's a late start for them. Later than I usually get out here. I can't get the cover off. Hold on. Okay. Got the jar off. Yeah, it's not very warm anymore. It's what I would call tap water warm. I don't know. If somebody watches how Lumnah do this with his pigs. I'm going to go get this water, which is fresh. It is also slightly chlorinated. Hey, ladies. So we have the upper latch, the lower latch. We have the string over here that I got to catch, so I got to do this. I got to do that. Grab this, give it a tug so it stays tight up against the coop over there. Let me wrap this around here. Let me try to get it under like that one good time. Maybe two. And that's it. Right, ladies? So we're going to go give them. Actually, I'm going to sneak this in here now. This, you can see, gets their attention. What did I grab for it? I'm going to put some of that in there. Ah, this is a new trick, girls. Wait till you see what I'm going to do. So I leave that there so that when friends and whoever come to visit, they can give them some. But the most they'd ever give them is that amount, which will be a very large amount. So now to promote them scratching and digging in the back over here, I'm going to throw this out into the yard. And they are right here. They know the drill. What do you say, girls? Where do you want to dig around today? Huh? And that will be their reason to scratch out here today. Let's see, we're missing one. This is the dark brown one. And I'm going to also open up the kitty, because I'm going to be around here for a while. So we have this convenient little pass through. A bit of a contortion act for me. I'm tall, it's short. So I'm going to pull. We this up. Do the same kind of a knotting there. And then we just throw that over there. And we got that open. This is the accommodations they have in here. They did make a nest up here. So I hope that by taking the straw down, that they don't make that into a nest on the bottom. They could, but I'm hoping they won't. So hopefully it'll just be a place they go to hang out when it's raining. All right, let's close this up. And I put this little cheap carabiner on here because God, one of them does stay in there at night. Let's see, okay, I'm gonna stop this because I think I'm spun around silly backwards. Sorry about that spinning and a little bit of whatever they call it when you get dizzy. And here they are, hopefully gonna put some fertilizer in there as they're doing their chow. Garbage in, garbage out. So far everything's looking pretty good. They have spread out the wood chips from the coop very, very well. I'm happy about that. You can see in the back how it's much more evenly dispersed. That just gives it time. I'll put in the next one probably right in this area here. That's a blueberry that's got a shroud around it just to keep them from pecking at it. I don't know if they will, but just play it safe. And then here, they don't seem to be too fond of squash. I don't know if it's because the squash was not particularly good, but I don't know. They don't eat it. I thought they would. They don't like it. So I'm hoping to get them stirred up in here too. These are all just leaves from an oak tree. And you can see here, it's a good example, as I go down in close, you'll see the progress there is on how they can convert this. Eventually you're gonna see that it really is just dirt. And good stuff. The worms love this. The girls love digging around in it. Come the spring, it's going to be devoured by the worms and by the girls eating the worms too. So along the fence here I have 4x4s laying down. And they run the whole length of this piece of vinyl fence. And that's just as a precaution. My next door neighbor over here on this side of the property, he has a fence that goes around. He used to have a dog, so it's a chain link fence. It was dog proof. Big dog proof, not small. And the neighbor back here has dogs. He's got a dog proof backyard. In the corner back here, these trees, things can climb up, jump in. They get sort of stuck back here. So I have to, not much I can do about it. I don't know. We'll see. And it's a beautiful sunny day today, very warm. I'm gonna get some work done on the, yeah, look at that. What's going on there, Haley? Huh? I didn't see who gave me eggs so far. She might be looking for a place to squat. Or I say copper squat, my wife says papa squat. She's from the Bronx, she says she knows better. All right, I put my overhead wire string back up. All right, girls. Not good enough for you? Huh? So this is the tarp roof modified with duct tape. Gorilla tape and silver duct tape. It's probably very overexposed because the sun is coming through. Of course, I had to work under treacherous conditions with the wild chickens. but I believe I have crown
all the way.
Whatever hits up against that wall will come down, but that's T111 that's been painted over here. So I believe they will get a little bit run off down, but so far so good as far as it doesn't go underneath. It stays dry under there. If it does, it only gets wet a little out here. Okay, so now maybe this will help illustrate. These two boards, these are just holding that in place temporarily. That should be folded over. But I have now this styrofoam board in here, which when it's installed like this gives me the ability to have solid walls. It's extremely light, and for just putting compost and wood chips in, it holds up just fine. I put the duct tape along the edge thinking it'll save the edges a little bit. Jury's out on that, it didn't stick so well. Could be temperature too. So now the concept is if I frame my chicken coop tractor inside this, I can put these sideboards up and have wind protection from the side inside this trailer if I need to, which is, I think, what I'm going to do. Bye-bye. So one of the things I like about this trailer is that it is a galvanized trailer that has a gate that will come off on the back. It has opened up on me twice when I wasn't expecting it to, so it's possible it's not the best design. But this will come up and off and goes right over here. So that can come off, don't need it. And the original theory is, or was, to put two bys, two by eight, like this, which you can see comes down right at the end and comes right down at the end. But I've since concluded that I think I'd like to put this styrofoam in so that it will act as a wall . And I came up with this idea for holding in things like leaf mulch. But my game plan was, I have these two top rails to be cut down to 8-footers. Excuse me, 5-footers. And potentially use them now something less than 5 feet. And this piece here is a 10-footer that I was going to cut in half, figuring I might as well just get one 10-footer, cut it in half, there's my two fives to go across here. So now I'm thinking, I guess I should consider having the foam board in here. This is like a three-ring circus here. But with those two pieces there like that, I think this one is designed to sit in here and hold those two in place. Could be wrong. So gotta just work this out here. This will go in, these two pieces come on the side and go back a little further, I guess. And once they're done, well, I'll show you. Hold on. Give you some ideas of the clearances. A little room on this side so that if I put an outboard wheel, it should still be able to roll up onto here. So as you can see, it's about 2 inches. Who knew that this glue was going to dry white? Now that it's drying, it's going to be all over the place. I was very liberal with it because I wanted it to do some stuff for me that, Maybe it will, maybe it won't. I haven't decided what I want to do. This would be the entry door on this end. Doesn't fit. Well, I guess it would fit without the styrofoam in. It will fit in with the gate on the back, which is a good thing for transporting. But I haven't decided how I'm going to set up a doorway over here yet. Don't know yet. I'll figure something out. Bye-bye. So this is how far I got today. Just have the bottom tops, some overlapping here. You can see some glue. I'm a little liberal with the glue. And these are 2.5 foot high walls. And we're going to see how that works out. I haven't decided yet on the opening on this end, or on that end for that matter. We'll have to see.